So, having said this, will allow you to work remotely. Having said that, once you are on the platform, you will be able to see, can you see or hear EndNote? So you'll be able to see EndNote. Click on that. So whatever user ID password combination you have used on Web of Science, that should also work on EndNote. Now let us go and see exactly what EndNote allows you to do. EndNote is a reference management tool. What do you exactly mean by a reference management tool? I'm sure all of us, when we write manuscripts or our thesis dissertations, we face a big problem. The first problem is how do I keep track of all the literature that I have read, right? How do I create a library? Many of us use less than optimal ways or means to do so. We probably put the URLs in a page. We also sometimes create a folder of PDFs, but it's difficult to find references, right? So EndNote makes this extremely simple. Whenever you're doing a literature search on Web of Science or Google, once you like a paper, you can you absolutely import it and create a library in EndNote. So as I said, once you are on EndNote, this is how your platform will look. Now, what I'm going to discuss here first is how do I take my references and import my references onto EndNote and create a library. That is the first thing. Second thing we will be talking about, how do I make a formatted bibliography according to the required journal style in a Word document. Okay, so first let us go to Web of Science. So this is for all the participants, and especially the participants who are from Vishwabharati University. As I said, Vishwabharati has a Web of Science access. Please talk to your library about that. And I have already given you the technique for accessing this particular platform remotely. So let us say I do a search on Web of Science. I'm just taking a simple, you know. Okay, I'm just searching for agrarian crisis. And I see there are a lot of papers, right? Give it a minute. So can you see over here? And let me just use my annotation. Can you see over here? Export, right? Can you see export? This is where you will use. This is the place you will use to export it to EndNote. Let me stop my annotation. I click on export and you see EndNote online. I click on EndNote online and ask me how many records do I need. I can select as many records that I want, let's say the first two, or I could have chosen export.
Hello, madam, you are not audible.
Yes, I had purposely muted myself because I had some
Okay,
background noise. So
no
export
problem.
import EndNote online, choose source title abstract. Please remember, this is the technique to export to EndNote online. And let me stop my annotation. And once you have exported, you should be seeing this particular, you know, icon that shows that you have already exported. Now, this is very important because if you are doing the same search later on, you will be able to understand which are the papers that you've already exported to EndNote. Now, this is the first technique that I have covered. How do I take references that I'm reading on Web of Science and transfer them to EndNote? Now, let us say I am reading something on Google, okay? So if you can see my page, I'm going to Google. Let me go to Google Scholar. So I am gone to Google Scholar. Can you please log in with your Google account? That is nothing but your Gmail account. Once you are on Google Scholar, can you see over here? Settings. And bibliography manager. I am again starting my annotation to make it more clear. Can you see bibliography managers? You go to settings, go to bibliography manager, say show links to and I have circled this place. You should be. What is the path? I will again write it over here. So, Google Scholar. Go to my settings. Then, on Bibliography Manager. To import citations is EndNote and save it. So this is how you will do it on Google Scholar. Now, once you are on Google Scholar, please remember, okay, I'll just save it now. Now, when you're doing a search, you need to be logged in so that you can have a My Library, create a library and do a batch import. So that searches, I will take the same keywords, agrarian crisis. It's a crisis in India. Can you see it's a book? These are books. This is from EPW. What I have done, and these are all in my, and these are, if I click over here, they all are in my library. This is how I will import them into my library. So let's say I want to import this particular paper and this paper. And this paper, right? Let's go to my library now. Can you see? I have these three papers now. So I am going to click on these three. And if you notice, this is the export button. EndNote. Can you see citation 6.w? Right? I have got a file. So please remember, when you are exporting from Google Scholar, the extension is .env. Now go to EndNote, back into EndNote. Over here, again, I'm using my annotate function. Can you check over here, collect? When you are doing on Web of Science, all your references go to My References. But if you are importing from any other platform, you need to go to Collect, okay? Import references. Import option will be EndNote import. Choose your file. You can choose your file from downloads. Typically, this is where your citations will be there. Open. Select, you can select a folder, any folder, or unfiled, wherever you want. And I'll show you how you can create folders. And you see, three references were imported. So we will reiterate this again. I will reiterate this using the annotate function again. How do you do it? On Google Scholar, click on the star icon below each reference. Go to My Library. Select references you want to import. Once use the export button on EndNote, go to tab select. Once you have gone to the tab select, import references. Select import option. What is the select import option? EndNote import. If you select EndNote import, you can select. So I hope everybody has got the entire pathway of how do they import references from Google Scholar, right? Now the same technique we will use for PubMed. I'm stopping my annotation. We will now go to PubMed. Okay, once you're on PubMed, can you see over here your references? You can send your references to a citation manager. So let's say these first two references, I'm just sending it to the citation manager. You can create a file. PubMed file is always .nbib. Choose a file. PubMed, COVID-19 set 4, open. Import option now should be PubMed, not EndNote import. PubMed, and then you can select either a group or end file. Import. Two references were imported. Whenever you are importing any references, they typically go to the unfiled. You can make or I can create files. If you remember, there was an option of creating files over there. New file, or if you have references over here from this list, you can click on these lists and you can create a new file. Let's see three references. I can add them to a group and I can create a new group. So for example, if I create a group today, Vishwabharati. Okay, and I see that it's over here. Three references have been added onto this. This is how you can create folders. This is a very, very important feature of EndNote. This allows you to basically archive and arrange your references. So according to the manuscript, according to the project that you all are working on, you all can get various such folders. So on EndNote, if you want, you can also use EndNote to do an online searches on several freely available databases, notably the Library of Congress and the PubMed. So you can go to online search on EndNote and do the searching from there on. So for example, over here, I have selected as my favorite National Library of Medicine. You just select as, you know, whatever reference databases you have access to. We have a lot over here. So whatever you all have access to, National Library of Medicine was selected, freely available. I can connect. So can you see I'm connecting to National Library of Medicine? And I can select using many things. For example, the mesh term. So corona viridian. Can you see I have got coronavirus results? I can, so I am doing the search on Web of Science. So if you want to do a search on Web of Science, on EndNote itself, rather than going to PubMed, separately, you can do that too. Next is organize your groups. Now, if you notice, we have created multiple groups. Now, this is very important feature, especially for teachers. Let's say you're teaching a class and you want to keep on sending your students a list of documents, a list of articles that they must be reading before each class. So rather than emailing people every time, you can create a text file with the emails of all your students. Just make sure these students have created an EndNote account of their own. That should not be a problem, because if you are a Vishwabharati professor, your students also have access to Web of Science. They can come into the campus, login and create an Web of Science user ID password, which works for EndNote also. And once they have created that, that's their EndNote user ID, that account detail. You can use that email. So what I'm going to do now is show you how to manage your group. So for example, manage my group. So these are the groups that you have created. Remember, I said once you have references, you can create groups and put particular references. So basically creating folders for which represent one project or one manuscript. So let's say I want to share this particular group, somebody which has 31 references. All I need to do is click over here. Manage sharing. Whom do I want to share with? So zero emails to start sharing this group. I can put up to 100 email addresses, 100 email addresses. And this is a very good technique for creating a reading list for sharing with your students. Next, we come to format. Now, this is a very important, technique. So for example, if you want to export references using a certain bibliographic style, so please come over here. So first thing that I will show you is, if you go to the downloads button over here, there is a plugin that you can download. So the plugin is different for different word processing systems. If you're using the Windows system, please use the download Windows. And please give me 1 second as I share with you a particular document.
visible.
Yes, give me one second, sir. Can you see my screen now? I hope everybody can.
Yeah, we are seeing. Yes.
So if I just write up, let's say I write two sentences, a quick fox. Sentences over here. So I have already downloaded my particular plugin, and you can see the plugin, it looks like this over here. So I can insert a citation wherever I want to insert my citation. My cursor should be there. I go over here, insert. So, for example, I've typed in. Now, you can just type in a particular keyword. There is no need to actually go physically. So, for example, I have a lot of references I know with P53, which is a particular tumor suppressor gene. So, I'm just going to say P53 and fine. So, here. Citations. So, can you see the moment I just clicked over here? Let me insert some more citations. So, So let's select this particular paper with R, okay? And I can even look into the paper, the words, the abstracts, I can read. Now, why is this very important is maybe at times we have a lot of references. We are not really sure which reference we want to put in, right? So instead of actually going through and, you know, kind of scratching our heads with reference to put in, all we need to do is go to our library and put in some keywords, right? I have put here P53, so put any keywords, you know. And it will, so let me put some other keywords, let's say MDM2. It has started finding out other references. I can even use terms which are, for example, if I have a reference which has the address in the address Kanpur. Can you see? It is searching for that also. So even if you know that from which a particular university or organization a particular reference is, you could even use that. So for example, say this, insert. 1, 2, 3, I put 3 references. Now instead of, and can you see the style? It, you can select any journal. So I have selected, let's say A6 now. Automatically, the referencing changes. This is a very, very useful tool for writing manuscripts and dissertation. Automatic reference style changes. Okay, so let's use another one. MHRA. NLM. Toxicology, environmental sciences. Can you see every time the reference is changing, annotated has the whole coming in. we don't want annotated. Let's say we want Chicago, 17 footnote. And you see, they're just set. So basically the one that the particular, this is, I think the Chicago 17 footnote works very well for people in the humanities. Depending on what journal style you need, you can, you know, use it. Caribbean 9 footnote, all of them are done, you know. Now, let us go back to the EndNote. Can you see my EndNote screen now? I hope my EndNote screen is seen now. Let us go to bibliography. To how do I get those styles? We have more than 7,000 styles. How do we get those few styles over there? So I can select a group of references, right? And I can select my bibliography style. I can select from favorites. And you see, there are different favorites. There are almost 7,000 different styles you can add to your list. All you need to do is click over here and get added to your list. Right? If you don't want to write your, you know, use the inline manuscript citing tool, you can also export reference a particular style. So I can click export references. So let's use Vishwabharati demo, export style, EndNote export, and I can even preview and print. Okay. Let's go back to our Word document to see how do I change. So back to my Word document. Now I have them in an EndNote. Let me use another style, APS6, quickly. Okay, APS6 or a numeric style maybe. NLM is a numeric style. Okay. Let's use over here one more insert. Let's use this paper, insert, so forth. Okay. So now how do I manage my time? Let's say I think that this paper should be somewhere else. Okay. So what I can do is, I can read the citation over here, and in this particular place, I can edit the reference and say, okay, insert a citation, insert particular citation here. Okay, now I am changing the order also. And you see, I can change the order also. Citation 1, 2, 3. I can also remove a particular citation. So let's remove this particular citation. Let's remove this citation. Remove citation. Okay. Can you see this citation? One of the citations removed. Edit and manage citation. Instead of this edit citation, I insert one more citation. I can remove this one also. And over here, I insert a citation. So let me use another keyword. Can you see? Automatically the citations are changed. So this is a very, very good technique. So whenever you are doing putting your references into and using the EndNote site while you write to it, please note that you must use the edit manage citation. Please do not just click backspace or delete a citation. Please go to edit and manage citations. When you are in the process of submitting your final manuscript, let's say as a PDF copy to your dissertation committee or to the journal editor, you can convert the citation to plain text. Okay, the document has not yet been you'll create two documents. One, the document which has the field codes, and one document which does not have the page to EndNote. And please use the document which does not have the page. Okay. You can click on instant formatting is on or off. You can even configure your instant formatting. So scan for temporary citation check, etc. Now we also have what we call a manuscript matcher. Let me go back. Let's go to manuscript matcher. Manuscript matcher is an amazing platform for deciding which journal you can send your articles to. Basically, how it works is that it will look for journals that have a similar kind of keywords which you have used in your manuscript, those in other journals. So you can use and that can allow you to find which are the journals which are the best fit for your manuscript. For example, let's use these as an example just to showcase it. I'm typing an abstract that I've taken. Also using land grab, a gradient crisis. Let us see what does our manuscript matcher throw up. So can you see it's giving me different sustainability agrarian change. Let's say this is a journal that I really want to, and it's giving me the impact factor also. I can go to journal information, I can go to this. If I click on submit, it will be to the submission page of the journal. Right. The final thing I want to discuss is a plugin that we have, which we call the EndNote Reference Capture. So please type in EndNote Reference Capture. Right, EndNote Reference Capture. And once you click on this, you should be able to find this particular. So can I just use my annotate again? So this is the platform we'll be looking into, and this is EndNote Reference Capture, how it looks. And what are you going to use it for? Let me show you an example. So once you have the EndNote Reference Capture browser extension added on to your browser, if let's say you are searching for papers, when you're doing, so you don't even have to go and import it into EndNote. So let's say this particular paper, you think this is a really important paper, this is a good paper, you're reading it, all you need to do is just click over here. And automatically, the bibliographic details will be extracted and you can add this. This is even simpler than an import, okay? So at this point, I will wrap up and I will just reiterate what we have learned so that this can help you all to ask questions. I request all the participants to take 5 minutes and start typing in your questions in the chat window. So I'll just reiterate what we have learned. First thing we have learned, the three different ways to import references into EndNote. One from the Web of Science, one from Google Scholar, one from PubMed. We have also learned that there is a browser extension called EndNote Capture Reference that allows you to extract all the bibliographic data from a paper and put it into a reference format, and that is saved in EndNote. Once you have the references in EndNote, At that point, you can create folders, segregating like research. So you can have folders for different manuscripts and different projects. And you can name these folders. You can also share your references. You can share references to other people who have an EndNote account. 100 email addresses at a time. You then need to go to your format tab on EndNote that allows you to format the references according to the journal style. EndNote has 7,000 journal styles available. They are all there in an indexed alphabetical format. In order to insert your references into your manuscript directly, please download the Cite While You Write plugin from the download section of this platform. Once you have downloaded that particular Cite While You Write plugin, that plugin is shown on the ribbon of your Word software, Microsoft Word software, on the ribbon, top ribbon. It will come as EndNote. Click on that. You will be going to insert citations. You can search for your references using any keywords that are present in the reference. And by that, I mean any word in the title, abstract, the author keyword, notes, etc., or the organization name. We just saw that. And you will insert references. Whatever styles that you want to use, those styles you need to add to your EndNote favorites button, and the formatting changes instantly. So if you do not like a style, immediately formatting can change. Now, when you are going to be submitting this paper, please preserve one copy of the paper which has the key field codes. Right now, you saw that this instant formatting and the formatting exists because the references in that particular document are linked to your EndNote software. But you can also create a plain text of these references, but do keep the original copy, which will be very helpful. Let's say you get a rejection from the journal or you decide that you don't want to submit to that journal anymore. You can go back and change the formatting, right? And once you want to change the order of references, etc., please go to edit and manage citation. Finally, also talked about the manuscript matcher function that allows you to find best fit journals by putting the title and the abstract of your unpublished manuscript. This is all on EndNote. So I will end the session at this point, but I am opening up for questions and answers. So please, I'll take a 5 minutes over here. I urge and persuade all the participants to please type in their questions to me at this point.
Thank you, madam. One question is there. Hello, am I audible, madam?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
One question is already come from to me. That is, what is the difference between EndNote and Mendeley?
Mendeley is also reference management software, but the number of journals they cover, the journal styles they cover, those are different from us. And EndNote has better import functions than Mendeley. EndNote also allows. I have personally seen that EndNote works better for styles which are more related to the humanities, especially APA and now the numbered styles, the styles where you have author like alphabetic, those styles they seem to work better, most stable with EndNote. And EndNote has more number of journal styles incorporated than Mendeley. The question is, compatible in LaTeX? So the Cite While You Write plugin is not compatible LaTeX, unfortunately. However, sir, if you remember, you can still format all your references and export the references. So though you will not be able to inline, you know, use that plugin feature, you can go to EndNote, make a, like, let's say make a folder. That folder has all your references. Format that entire folder into the journal style you require, and then manually insert the formatted references as required. Does that make sense?
So any question from the audience, please write to the madam.
There is one more question. Can you use it offline? Yes, sir. Offline you can use, but not this particular version. We have a subscription version called EndNote Desktop. That can be used offline. EndNote Desktop is a subscription version. And so the question from Monoji Gora is, how can we get EndNote? So the version that I have today demonstrated, that is already available to you. It's complimentary. And if you want the subscription version, that is available online, offline use. Okay, and that has some more features. For example, in the subscription version, you can actually create your own style. So if Vishwa Bharati or any other university has a citation style which is not matching that of any of the standard style or a journal style, you can do that. You can create and edit known styles. You can attach and name PDF. Okay, like for example, if you have a beautiful PDFs that all those PDFs can get attached and made into a library of references. All the bibliographic data is extracted, references are created. So those are the extra features of the offline version, subscription version. So if you would like to talk about, you know more about that, just write to us. But otherwise, the online version is complimentarily available to all of you who have ever. We are also running note certification series in the middle of July. So all of you who are interested in the series, please let us know and we can send you a link to join. It is a series of 4 lectures, and at the end of that, you will be given a quiz to share, you know, a test on how much you've understood how to use EndNote. And based on your performance, you also get a certificate. So this is my email ID. Some of you who are interested in registering for that certification series, by the way, the certification is free of cost. There is no charge associated with that. But if you are interested, please write back to me and I will make sure you are registered. Any more questions? I hope none of you will, manually format references. At least that much I hope. What are the changes made by Google? I am sorry, I cannot answer for Google Scholar. Unfortunately, I am not from the Google Scholar team. So again, anybody who wants to attend our certification series, you are most welcome. Please write to me and we will. I have put my email address. Let me just put it on the screen also once again. So give me a second, sir. So just doing the annotate again. This is my email address. If anybody would like to, is there any option to add reference in EndNote? Yes, that is the whole point of EndNote. You can add references to add the references 3 ways, and we've already discussed: one from Web of Science, one from Google Scholar, and one from PubMed. any question that you have, or if you would like to join the EndNote certification series, please write to me at my email address on the screen.
So any more question from the audience?
Are there references in EndNote manually? So I don't understand exactly what is your question. Manually, you can always, you know, import a reference into EndNote. So if are you asking me the kind of a reference? So let's say you are talking about a reference that you cannot find on the web. If that's your question, on the web version, you cannot do that, unfortunately. On the subscription version, that is an offline version, there is a provision where you can go to a reference form and then add the title or thing separately and create a formatted reference. Yeah, that is there on the offline subscription version. On the online version, your reference should be there somewhere present on the internet, and you are importing that into the online version, if that makes sense.
Okay, thank you, ma'am, for your informative, very, very informative deliberation. And ma'am also given put his mail ID on the screen also. And if you have any question, you may write to ma'am through mail. And let me end the meeting right now. Okay, thank you, ma'am, once again.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for organizing this session. I hope all of you have found this useful, and you will be using EndNote or a similar reference management software, not manually formatting your references anymore. And I hope
we are using this EndNote from since 2015. So Vishwarati is using this.
Absolutely. And sir, if Vishwanath is using that, please, sir, I will send you the details of our certification series. You can research scholars to maybe register for that. That will be a very in-depth session with quizzes and case studies. So it will be 4 sessions. So that will probably be more in detail, and you know, we cannot unfortunately cover everything in detail in a 1 hour session, but that will also have some hands-on exercises. So thank you so much, sir, and I will wrap up. Thank you, and I wish you a very
it is for your kind information that very frequently we conducted this type of program for our internal research scholar. So there were different type of reference and tools here. EndNote is one of the important tools we speak on this topic. So we are keeping touch with our research scholar with this topic. So in next time, whenever we will make this type of national-wide program, then obviously we will touch with you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
partition will be there.